Throughout the history of life on Earth, there has always been a shadow cast upon it, that at any moment an asteroid or comet could enter the atmosphere and detonate with such force as to cause a mass extinction, such as the one that killed off most of the dinosaurs. Think on that. Hundreds of millions of years of evolution was needed to reach an amazing animal like a Tyrannosaurus rex. And then it was snuffed out, just like that, by the very thing that may have originally seeded the chemical building blocks of life on Earth. T-Rex met with bad luck indeed. But that moment of a bad spin of the cosmic roulette wheel led to the rise of the mammals, and ultimately us, the first species on this planet that can understand, detect, and deflect asteroids and mitigate this great threat to life on Earth. And we're getting better at it. Humans and dangerously large meteorites have a long history. Perhaps the most famous impact crater on Earth, Barringer Crater in Arizona, or at least the best preserved, is only about 50,000 years old. While there probably wasn't anyone in North America at the time to witness it, humans were already living on planet Earth when that crater was formed. Had someone saw it, they would have witnessed the equivalent of a 10-megaton nuclear blast, where the 160-foot-wide iron asteroid fragment that created the crater would have entered the atmosphere amid blinding light, struck the Earth, and exploded, vaporizing most of the meteorite in the process. The vaporized metal would have then fallen to Earth as iron rain, which to this day can still be picked up in the area with a magnet. Anything alive within miles of the impact, though, would have died instantly. But this is not the only case of a large meteorite smacking Earth and doing damage. Two events during the 20th century stand out, not so much for the damage they did, but the damage they could have done if they hadn't struck remote areas. Both happened in Siberia, the first in 1908 causing the famous Tunguska blast. This blast remains somewhat of a mystery since it was an airburst and not a lot of material has been recovered that could shed light on the nature of the object. As a result, it might have been larger or smaller than the object that caused Barringer Crater, depending on the density of the object, and current estimates put the size of the blast at about 5 megatons. Had this happened over a city, the effect would have been many times worse than the atom bombs dropped on either Hiroshima or Nagasaki. The second event also happened in Russia. In 1947, the 200,000-pound Sakhody-Alin iron meteorite entered the atmosphere and basically went off like a grenade, peppering a mountainside with twisted iron shrapnel fragments. Again, had this happened over a city, it would have been devastating. More recent examples would be the Chelyabinsk meteorite from 2013. This 12,000-metric-ton asteroid fragment shattered windows across its path and caused numerous injuries, again over Russia, which is due to Russia's enormous landmass. It's a big target, but the oceans present an even bigger target, and it's estimated that Hiroshima-class explosions from asteroid fragments happen more than once a year on planet Earth, typically over water. So fast forward to last Saturday. A 6-foot rock barreled into the atmosphere over Botswana at an estimated 38,000 miles per hour and detonated in the sky. 6-foot rocks falling to Earth from space is nothing unusual, it happens all the time. But this one stands out because it was detected before it entered the atmosphere. Scientists at the Catalina Sky Survey spotted the object hours before, when it was about the same distance away as the moon. Scientists quickly realized that it was going to collide with Earth, and were able to make predictions of just where it was going to hit, somewhere in southern Africa. It turned out to be Botswana, and it was caught on camera. And no doubt meteorite hunters are on the scene as I speak, combing that country looking for chunks. So while asteroids and comets remain a very real threat to human civilization, we're also getting better at detecting them. Spotting a 6-foot rock at the distance of the moon is pretty amazing when you think about it, though more funding is needed to truly set up a method of detecting and deflecting dangerous asteroids. But one thing is clear, if we're smart, it won't be long before Earth is no longer subject to mass extinction by asteroids. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently flip-flopping. I recently accused the birds of complacency when it comes to asteroid impacts, but then someone pointed out to me that they survived the dinosaur mass extinction. Clearly they know something we do not, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.